Do you agree with the elector going against the will of the people in their state and changing their vote for you?
Well, he's gone along with the will of the Constitution, the way the Constitution was written originally, even though they haven't followed it, was to send special people from the community to go to a convention and pick the president. And it's been changed in some states. The state legislatures have the authority to design the rules and regulations on what they have to do. In Texas, there's no rule that says you must do this or you'll be fined or you'll go to prison, nothing like that. 26 states do that, and they have the right to do this. So he is following the rules. He's not following traditions because the original intent of the founders didn't last very long. Immediately got into this partisan thing and popular votes, and it's drifted away. So he had a goal. He had a goal. He wanted to send a message. But no, he doesn't deserve punishment, but it might motivate Texas or any other state to change the rules.
Yes.
But I sort of like the original. I like to see minorities protected. I'd like to change the way the Electoral College works. I'd like to see it percentage-wise. So if 10% of the vote goes to libertarians,
it's like a parliamentary
they ought to get 10 votes.
Yeah,
to pick this. And so I think that would be worth thinking about.
All right. I think, by the way, the answer to my question, to put it simply, was yes, is what you just said. But let me switch to something else, because the Electoral College vote, you know, a lot of people were calling for an investigation of the Russia hack to the DNC and the email situation with WikiLeaks. All that's died down. Was that a political stunt by the Democrats, or is there truly still a need for this to be investigated?
Well, you know, I guess everything gets investigated, but I think it's politics more than anything else. But it's really nothing new. It's like this, you know, guess what? Somebody might have done ABC. And then they very rarely, if ever, compare what we do with elections around the world. And we are interfering all the time. I'm sure the Russians are interfering. But when you lose, you can jump on that and make a big point of it. But I don't think it made any difference. I think it's insignificant. But if you review the history of how many elections we've been involved with, how many countries we invited, how many people we have killed in order to have our guy in, I'll tell you what, we don't have much room for condemning anybody else because I think the spying and the interference, it's sort of that nature of governments. That's why I like to see government much smaller.
All right.